Really think these will come down in one piece?
I don't think I understand how you can use this to make the table.
Come on, baby. Come on. Come on.
One more. Whoa, whoa. One more.
Look at that.
That is a pretty piece of wood.
Isn't that pretty?
It is. That one's even prettier. That one's so pretty down there.
It's gonna be real nice.
Erin doubted me, my own wife. Jonathan, my project manager, I doubted myself. But, you know, I rose above it. I rose above my own doubt.
You're the man,
babe. I didn't think it could be done.
You are the man.
Thank you.
Like a glove, brother.
Dang, man.
It is so much friendlier. She hated that old door, you know? No window, no detail, nothing, and then metal bars in front of it. But now, it looks like it's smiling, like the front of the house is smiling.
Welcome.
In. Welcome.
Nice, Macy.
Thank you.
What's up, Dubs?
What's happening, bud?
You doing all right?
Man, yeah, how about you?
Golly, this is all looking great. You got the new built-ins over here, Don. That's way better than what they had there originally. That's awesome. What do you think about this?
That's your project, I think. Yeah.
In order to beef it up for the countertops and to make it fit with our new cabinets, we're gonna have to do a little bit of modificating, and that is a word, I made it up.
I realized that we probably could have trashed this, and you would probably be already finished in here.
Oh, yeah.
I've been catching flack about this kitchen island at Ms. Barnes' house everywhere I turn. It is a prefab setup. I get that. We're gonna have to, you know, shim it here, adjust it here, get it tight, and Stubbs doesn't like that, and I know why. He builds custom cabinets.
Just think, we could have had one built, one section, been through and done.
I get it. But once we're finished, this is gonna be awesome. I'm telling you, Stubbs.
And I didn't say it wasn't gonna look good. I just said we'd have been through yesterday if we hadn't done it.
Okay, suddenly this thing looks real nice.
I'm feeling it, dude.
Wait till we get them corbels on there. You're gonna be impressed.
That's it.
Dude, I mean, I hate to brag, but I don't really. So I think this is awesome.
It ain't bad, I'll guarantee you.
We got flooring, countertops, and paint. We still got a long way to go. It's coming there, though. It's coming together.
Hey! What's going on?
Well, we're looking for a hide, like an animal print. I feel like you have a zebra rug, don't you?
I have something on either aisle one or two.
Animal prints, zebra. It's way outside my norm. But I'm really excited because like, I think when you use just a little bit of animal print, it's just enough. She sat down this aisle. Oh my gosh, that mannequin just really scared me so bad. No zebra. It's kind of hard to miss zebra print rug. Zebra, zebra, zebra. Oh, that's it. I knew I saw it.
There it
is. I knew. Miss Barnes loves animal prints, zebra especially. Mm-hmm. Most of the time, people want to keep things neutral. I think people are afraid to use vivid, bold color and pattern, but Miss Barnes is into it.
I'm allergic to cats. You think I'll be allergic to zebra?
Oh, it's not real. Definitely
it's
not.
It's definitely not. No, it's definitely not.
Time for the island countertop. In all total, we're looking at 693 pounds.
Come on, baby.
Think it'll hold it?
Now's not the time to doubt, Jonathan. Yeah!
There.
This looks like a custom-built island. Not like a repurpose make lemonade island. Look at it holding, plus 300 pounds.
I know.
There's 1,000 pounds on this thing right now.
Like sliding into home plate, because that's a home-run island.
This is really, really cool, babe.
Welcome to the Barnes house.
Wow! That is just fantastic.
I love that blue color.
Gorgeous.
Oh, and the flower boxes.
So these boxes, we actually built these in the shop.
Beautiful.
Before, the best thing about the house was the Chicago brick. So we didn't want to do anything with it.
Uh-huh.
And then there was that permanent planter with the brick retainer wall.
I hated that.
I know you hated it. And you also told us how much you hated the front door that had the metal bars in front of it. And so we wanted to just focus on making the house feel much friendlier and more welcoming.
Just what I wanted.
But the inside, you're not gonna believe.
Okay.
Isn't this better?
Absolutely
nice
gorgeous.
Front doors. Come check out your new dining room.
Wow! I can't believe this. This is gorgeous, girl.
This beautiful dining table, Ben built just for you.
Oh my goodness.
These boards in here are actually some of the beams that were in your living room.
Wow. I love these floors.
You like the floors?
Yes.
You remember the floors that were here?
Yes.
They're wearing Denny.
It's a manufactured floor. It's really durable, but it's the top half of the flooring is actually real oak now.
Okay.
And you can sand it and refinish it after, you know, it gets some beating and banging on it from grandchildren.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, we got those.
And I don't know if you remember, but this used to be a wall.
Uh-huh.
And we've now opened it up so it flows nicely into the rest of the living spaces.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go see your sitting room.
Okay. Wow! Girl, look at this.
Is that the piano?
That's your piano.
The piano my mom bought for me. Love this color.
I'm crazy about this color.
It just brings that, you know, I told you I had that Afrocentric desire.
I tried to take cues from that in every decision we made.
I love it. I love it. And look at this rug.
You said you loved Animal
Kingdom, yep.
It's a faux zebra rug. No zebras were injured in the making of the rug. Are you ready to see the family room?
I am ready.
All right.
Let's see it.
Whoa!
Take it all in.
I cannot believe this, girl.
This
is
oh,
one big room. It is gorgeous.
It is.
Look at the pillows. They're beautiful.
My mom and I made this for you from an authentic Kenyan kuba cloth.
Oh, that's so nice.
Isn't that cool?
Authentic. It is absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah.
Y'all remember what it looked like before?
Oh.
All of this was paneling.
Right.
We rebuilt the built-in here, but we built it in a way that we could paint it out and, you know, the fireplace.
The fireplace is
gorgeous.
Amazing.
Yes, Mallory and I whitewashed that together to make it just a little bit lighter, lighten it up.
So glad you guys kept some of the beams. And it doesn't feel as low as it did.
It would be a little bit boring.
It would without them. My favorite thing that changed the most is how much light is in the room. It's
like
that patio outside is a part of the living room.
Yeah, that's like a little paradise out there I set up.
It is.
You
know,
that really was one of my shining moments, I think.
Yeah, a real
shining
moment.
You have lots of shining moments.
That's right.
I know you do.
Let's go explore your kitchen.
Okay,
yeah, let's check out the breakfast nook and the kitchen.
Yes.
I can't wait. Oh my goodness gracious. I don't even remember, because this is...
I remember walls and paneling.
Yeah.
A lot of paneling, a lot of walls.
This is a little spot you can have a quiet breakfast, just you,
yes,
before everybody comes and blows up your house.
My favorite view of the house is from over here by the window. Isn't this incredible, this view?
There's just so much room in here.
Yeah.
It is just fantastic.
So open.
So in here, again, the flooring runs throughout, the granite, it's incredible.
The tile backsplash. I wanted to have something that was very patterned but subtle.
And we rebuilt all new cabinets in here.
Okay.
But this piece is actually original to the kitchen that came
across that way.
And it's really well made.
Mm-hmm.
These are all oak drawers and oak cabinets.
Nice.
But then my favorite little detail is it had the little cutting board in it.
Cutting board. I remember that.
That's so cool.
Mm-hmm. Another one of your shining
moments.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Barnes. Exactly.